Okay, so here we are at the 2019 Video Game Awards. Rob, what are you excited about?
I'm super excited about Red Dead Redemption 2. Arthur's really been putting in some work. What about, yeah, what about you?
Well, I'm really excited for that, what is it called? UPS the game.
You mean Death Stranding? Okay. Well, let's see what the winners are.
So, Rob, we have a lot of video games here.
That you don't play.
What's up? What are we talking about today?
So,
why is Phoenix on this cover?
Is that coincidence? I don't think. I don't know.
Fam, what's her name? Fam Jekin? Anyway, why are we here to
they
talk
all
about...
They have something in common, right?
These are awesome video games.
They're
in
all
2019.
Sealed.
You all can take your haterade and go out the door.
So the Video Game Awards.
The Video Game Awards.
VMAs, for short.
The VMAs.
Mm-hmm. It's the VGAs.
The VGAs.
You're
VGAs.
An idiot.
The VMAs and the VGAs are December 12th.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of great games that came out this year. In fact, I say 2019 is one of the strongest years of video games being released.
I disagree with that.
Yeah, I disagree with that.
Go ahead.
Too.
But
what are you talking about? We're in the. We'll talk about them. We'll get into it in just a second. So, I wanted to talk about what we thought of some of the games that are up for awards in the VGAs, and then talk about games that we think should have been there. Because I think there's some games that are not on the list that should be on the list.
So, what's on the list? Let's talk about that, Maddie.
We have a lot of different ones. Some I was surprised about because they just released, so I was not expecting them to be on the list. One of these is Death Stranding, a game that I did not believe was real until it actually came out. And I
November 8th.
I still don't believe it's real. But anyways, Death Stranding, the game we've been waiting for since Kojima
left Konami.
It was a bloody mess. Weird trailers.
Right.
Fantastic trailers that make no sense. Even when you play the game, it still doesn't
UPS
make sense.
The game
well,
has
no,
been
it
released.
Make sense.
It's the Postman with Kevin Costner, right?
But I'm going to tell you what. It's Norman Reedus, Miles Mikkelsen,
Matt Mikkelsen.
Leia, mm-hmm. Please say these names correctly. Leia Seam.
I thought I was bad.
Okay.
Yeah, there's a ton of celebrity and cameos too, right? We've got Junji Ito, we've got Conan O'Brien.
Conan, mm-hmm.
That was a good one.
Jeff Keighley, who is hosting the VGAs.
That's not fair.
Well, yes.
This came out in November, and it's already up for Game of the Year.
Yeah.
So
Kojima.
Yeah. So it's Kojima and Keighley, they have a great relationship. Now
has anybody here at the table played?
Yes. I am at chapter 4, so I've actually made a decent sized dent in it.
So you're about halfway through. It's what, 8 chapters on?
I think something like that.
How do you know?
Because
YouTube.
I watch Twitch.
Yeah. So the thing was interesting about
little
this.
Sister.
The thing that's interesting about this is when
no
I try
shame.
To describe some of the things that you do, it sounds horribly boring. Like I'm walking through a field and there's rocks and I drop a package and then I try to go get it and it washed down the shore and then I grabbed it and I took it to the station. That sounds incredibly
boring.
Yeah,
because you have to make
boring.
Sure you're carrying all your packages and they aren't falling over. And also you have to make sure the baby doesn't cry too much. Yeah.
It sounds like extremely tedious.
Does it give you a sense of isolation?
Yes and no. Isolation that you're wandering around this big, huge world. However, because
it's
this cool...
trying to connect people together.
It has this cool... You're right. You're trying to connect people. It has this cool Dark Souls-like thing where you're walking along and you'll see someone made a bridge or a ladder. And you can like it. And it's actually one a real person who's concurrently playing the game. And their stuff appears in your game. So you're like... Thanks for making this bridge.
Yeah, I always like that about Dark Souls too. Yeah. That you can see kind of hints from other players. They're like, hey, be careful right here. Or, hey, try this way. So it's the same way in Death Stranding.
Same thing. And it's awesome. It's really, really cool. Yeah. I'm having a lot of fun.
So right now, the way you're describing it, it sounds a lot like very atmospheric, like Ico and Shadow of the Colossus. Like where you have
comparison.
A mission. You have to be quiet, like a mission, and then there's this obstacles you got to get through, and you do. It's they kind of put you in the middle of nowhere, which is kind of like the way I felt about Metal Gear. Metal Gear puts you in that isolated state where you're alone, and your only communication is with through the radio, right? I'm talking original Metal Gear.
Oh, Kojima specifically said
solid.
He says specifically that those games, and he mentioned Ico and Shadow of the Colossus. Like when he was growing up, like he felt lonely a lot, so he wanted to create a game where you could feel lonely but still the networking thing allows you to feel connected.
So you have ghosts of interaction, which is so nice. It's not like a true MMO, but it's like these ghost interactions. So somebody did leave a presence, but yeah, you're just sort of experiencing that leftover presence.
I feel like you've played this game. You just don't know it yet.
What's next?
So another big one that's on all the lists for VGAs is Control. Mm-hmm. So actually, I had not heard of this game until I was looking up VGAs. I'm surprised because it was on all the lists, right? Yeah. So it's nominated for best game. It's nominated for several categories.
Besides Xbox One.
Everything.
Is it PC?
Everything.
PS4?
Everything. It's fantastic
Nintendo
on PC.
Nintendo Switch?
It's not on Nintendo Switch, but it's on Xbox, PS4, and PC. And it's beautiful on PC, RTX, da-da-da. But think of it this way.
Is it like a Max Payne?
If you had the force, but you were a strong Phoenix. Female protagonist.
Okay. Yeah.
So, like, when you said Phoenix, it's like, you kind of hit it on the money.
Yeah.
But it's also a really fun, tight shooting, third-person shooting, but with force, like, action.
Come on!
So, another one that I haven't played yet, but I'm very excited to pick up, is Outer Worlds. This was also nominated for a lot of different awards at the VGAs. Mm-hmm. This is by Obsidian, who made
the original Fallout in New Vegas.
In New Vegas, yeah.
And so, right. Like, think of, okay, I think Fallout has gone kind of cutesy and silly and goofy, yeah, and kind of pretend Fallout 1 was good. That's what the, okay,
yeah, so
Fallout
like
1 is good.
Returning back to Fallout, right, and a lot of the same kind of mechanics in the open world and the types of ways you interact with people, right? Mm-hmm. But space, colorful.
Cool branching conversations.
No money grab.
It's not no money right. grab, no funky DLC. Like it's a great space.
So it's first person. Is
yes.
it exploring
yes.
outer world?
Outer world. So you're actually on an outer world, and you start off in like you're on this outer world, and your team comes back, and they're trying to solve the mystery, but they're trying to get to this place, and they have to get a usual MacGuffin to get to this place to get their ship to get to the outer world.
Right.
So it's your adventures of doing that. But again, all the characters are great, graphics are great, shooting feels good.
Yeah. And it's also kind of like other Fallout where your main character, you know, he's on a mission to go to this this settlement, this colony, right? Mm. And somewhere along the way, he gets lost, he's in a coma or something for about 15 years. So these areas are already explored. There's already like different sects of people trying to like hash it out over territory, and you're just coming into this now, late.
Yeah.
It seemed very much like Firefly, the video game.
Yeah, that's
I can say that.
I think how Honest Trailer.
So, has anybody?
Have
you played this?
Then? Yes, I played it, but not a ton. But I have played it.
I'm about to jump into this.
Several chapters.
You're about to jump into that.
Yeah,
it looks.
I miss Fallout.
Yeah,
you know
that's the thing.
I wasn't a big fan of 4. I obviously didn't play that new
76,
one.
76. Yeah.
But Outer Worlds, like this, I'm looking for this kind of game again. Okay. It's been a while, and I would like.
Thing, I'm the one at the table that does not like these type of games.
Oh,
I love the idea behind creating your characters and spending hours doing that, and they look amazing, and the graphics look really cool. But Fallout was something I never got into, and I really tried, like both Fallout and what was the other one, Elder Scrolls, and Fallout New Vegas, and I tried, but it just wasn't for me. But that's okay. Smash Brothers.
Smash Brothers.
I did play that.
Yeah.
And I'm a huge fan of Smash Brothers, so much so that I got everything pre-ordered, all the new, including
Joker.
Are you okay?
Terry Bogard.
Right? Which I'm sure all the younger people are like, why is this truck driver driving and riding?
No, why is this Pokemon trainer so buff is what it was. That's what they were like. Why is there a buff Pokemon trainer?
I remember you and I doing our video game haul, and that trailer had just dropped, and we were both freaking out.
It was beautiful.
We were kids
beautiful.
Again. Like,
beautiful.
Oh my God, it's Terry. At first you think it's Hamaru, then it's Nakaruru, then it's, it's Terry Bogard. So I'm a big fan of Smash Brothers.
And you know, when we have parties,
ridiculous.
Everyone plays Smash. Everyone continues to play Smash. Yeah,
it's an easy game to pick up. I'm surprised it was nominated for best game because normally you don't see those types of games as nominated for best game. It's
like
more
just
a big
another,
story.
Yeah,
honestly, it should get credit where it's due because I mean, look how popular that's continued to be.
It moves systems.
Smash. Yeah,
right. It moves systems, and that's. I think, that doesn't define the game of the year, but it does help a little bit that, it sold a lot of systems for Nintendo. Mm-hmm. Because a lot of people went out and bought it just for that. Then Mario Kart, of course.
Mario Kart
was just a rehash of what the Wii U was.
So another one on the list is Sekiro, which is by From Software.
Dark Souls, right?
The people make Dark Souls and...
So it's very similar to that, except it's feudal Japan.
Yeah. Feudal Japan, Dark Souls, and Demon Souls. You're a ninja guy, you have an augmented hand.
And help me out here, I think both of you would know what this is. Bushido Blade? Is that the game?
Oh my god.
That's what it kind of reminded me of a little bit.
You guys,
the one hit.
You don't know how long I've been waiting to replay Bushido Blade.
We can do that tonight.
Okay.
So
yeah, think
very
like
similar. Not so much Tenchu, because Tenchu was more stealth was another, and assassin.
Yeah, this is very
more realistic, I guess, in a way, and difficulty.
This game,
very
the difficulty
high.
Is
and that's
all
the
roof.
Only reason I haven't picked it up, because when this first got announced, I thought, okay, I'm gonna pick this up for sure. But everyone talked about how hard it was. I was like, you know what?
In having grades of difficulty.
It's no shame in watching Twitch videos on somebody else
absolutely
playing it.
Absolutely not.
Again.
So it feels like you've played it yourself. That's
absolutely.
Amazing.
Well, no. If I don't have the time to play, I can engage in other media while I watch someone else, and I still get enjoyment. Boom.
I absolutely love Sekiro.
You call me a boomer?
I have not finished it because it is really tough, but it's one of those things where you die, you try again, you try again, you learn. Each time you get a little bit further, you take off more ticks off the boss, like you learn.
And I
love those. I'm kind of misogynist.
Well, and I love that part. Yeah. I love that about Dark Souls. Yeah. I love Dark Souls.
Yeah.
More than I ever thought I would.
And Ninja
that
Gaiden.
That being said, yeah. I was like, you know what? I'll keep Dark Souls, but I'm not going to do
this again.
I think that's what speaks to people probably... our age that grew up playing things like Mega Man, Mega Man 2, you had to learn the patterns, and video games don't really do that much until you had Dark Souls, right? Mm-hmm. Dark Souls, I remember being the first game that I'm like, oh my god, this is hard because I'm used to games being so much easier to you. But that and saving like every 5 seconds, where video games used to be hard, like, learning the patterns of the boss and having to do things over and over, replay value, whereas video games tended to be a lot easier these days. I thought that was pretty cool about Dark Souls.
Yeah, I can still complete Mega Man 2 on the hardest difficulty with, like, one dude. I can still do that
today. That's not bragging at all.
Well,
that, that's
so
the easiest Mega Man game.
Because they only had 5 levels, and it would have been way too easy.
There were 12 levels in Mega Man, but
well,
I hear what you're saying.
Have you played a Mega Man?
And also, those games cost $60, and they weren't that many. They didn't have 100 billion games coming out at the time. So like Sekiro, the difficulty, I love it. Like I think it's worthy.
What's next?
So
Maddie?
We only have a few more on here that are actually on the list. Mm-hmm. So we do have Gears 5, which Gears 5 wasn't actually nominated for as many as the other titles, which I was really surprised by, because when this came out, everyone was talking about it. So much so that I even was considering playing it, and I've only played maybe Gears 1.
Gears 1.
And that was still just a little bit. These are not my type of games. But when this got announced, I was like, I think I'm gonna play Gears 5.
And so, that's the thing.
I'm surprised I haven't. I have played every single one of the Gears games, including the spin-off Gears series. And I think my days of playing console games has been the Switch, because I can take it with me. Whereas Gears requires me to go online, ask one of my friends or brothers to play Gears with me, and most of the time they're too busy or I'm too busy.
There's Game Pass and there's XCloud coming.
I'm not
so you
playing
be able
that
to,
by myself.
You can take. You
I'm
play.
Not. I have friends, damn it.
So this Gears goes in a slightly different direction. The story's strong. The protagonist
spoilers.
Is cool.
Spoilers.
Like, spoilers.
Is that
we've got a
Phoenix's
we got a
daughter?
Yeah.
Is it Phoenix's daughter? I'm calling it right now. I bet it is. I haven't even played it.
No, I'm dying to play. And plus, it's voiced by Laura Bailey. I'm a big
Laura
fan
Bailey
of that voice
too.
Actress.
Yeah, I like her too.
And so when I heard she was working on it, and she was really excited to be working on it, I was like, well.
Who's Laura Bailey, Tina? She, help me out. Was she in Jurassic Park?
No, she's a VO
she
for
voices
tons
Trunks.
Of games.
Yeah.
She voices Trunks?
Yeah.
Oh, Kid Trunks.
Yeah.
Not Future Trunks.
Yeah.
Got it.
Okay. One of the final games that's on the Game of the Year list is...
Luigi's Mansion 3!
No, but also equally scary Resident Evil 2.
Yeah, Resident Evil 2.
And
that totally deserves it.
So, again, I have 6 jobs, 3 children, and I don't have that much time to play video games very often. Not only did I beat Resident Evil 2 all the way as Claire, because you always got to start as Claire, because
of
that booty. Then you got to go through again as Leon. I totally went through that again, and I went through all the DLC. The graphics are fantastic, gameplay's fantastic. It did so well that Resident Evil 3 is going to be...
Yeah. I just got announced at the time of the
this
today.
Recording.
You both have played it?
I played it and then got scared and turned off.
Okay.
That's a good way of playing. Okay, so question. Is it worth getting because there's more things that they added to the story, or is it the exact same story?
Okay, so the story is very similar, but it mostly follows the story of the PlayStation 2, but obviously enhanced graphics and things like that, but there's some things have changed. Some things have changed. So if you've played the original... 2, you'll be like, oh yeah, I remember that. Oh, they didn't have it exactly like that. Like the dude at the gun shop, there's some things that are slightly different. And then the DLC also expands into some of those characters and some of those things and
so it's a good remake.
It's a very good. It's not,
I think,
just
worth
like
it for graphics alone.
Honestly, most of the Resident Evil remakes have been great. I was a big fan of Resident Evil.
They do a very good job
on the GameCube. The remake of one was phenomenal.
Yeah, think along the lines of that remake. Like, it's the same, but it's different, and it's definitely worth going through if you're a Resident Evil fan.
So, since both, is that all the games, by the way?
That's all the games for the Games of the Year.
Game of the Year.
Both of you are the biggest video game players on the show. What would your Game of the Year be, Rob?
Well, for me, I'm
ladies first.
I don't know if I can give a good answer because I haven't fully played
14
anything on the list as far as like what's Game of the Year.
Okay. Well, neither has Rob.
That's not true.
If you know, by looking at what I do have experience with and looking at the list, my recommendation would be Resident Evil 2. But I also recognize that since that's a remake, maybe that's not what would win.
And yeah, that is kind of,
because we don't have a big, like, usually we have a big like RPG, right, or something like that. Like, we have Breath of the Wild, or we have
Kingdom Hearts 3. Guys, Kingdom Hearts 3.
We're not talking about that one.
Yeah,
let's skip over that one.
It did get nominated for best RPG, which is
did they have any choices with Tokidoki Panic 5 not out? Dragon Quest 11 came out last year though.
Okay, right. so
it doesn't count.
So, for
how did they not choose Link's Awakening? That by far is Game of the Year.
It's on the list.
It's, I think, one of the family games.
Why don't we talk about it? Oh, because it's not up for Game of the Year.
Yeah.
So I do believe like that Oscars. Link's Awakening was nominated for Best RPG, which I think
that makes. I could give it.
That is a beautiful remake.
I
love that game.
Kingdom Hearts 3 was also. I wouldn't recommend it. There's a few more that I didn't pick up.
A couple games that I played that I forgot because they were so early in the year, or they just poor Kingdom Hearts.
Yeah, like I
pigeon,
forgot
the pigeon game or the goose.
Oh, goose game.
So the Untitled Goose Game was nominated.
That's a Tina
for
game.
Indie.
That's a fantastic game.
So out of the indie games that were nominated for the different categories, the ones I have like any sort of relation to are
Untitled Goose Game and Gris.
Gris. Which talk a little bit about Gris.
Gris. Oh,
Gris is it's going through basically the stages of grief and emotion. And so you basically play as this character that, you know, obviously has experienced some type of loss or trauma, and is just totally blacked out. And they slowly regain colors and experiences and learn to move on from that. But it's a very artfully done game. Like, when people say, you know, video games, the old adage weren't, you know, art, this is definitely art. This is playable art.
I would say it's almost like something akin to Journey.
Yeah. Journey.
I can't help it. Every time a game like this comes out, I can't help but think of Journey, because to me, Journey's the game that was
first,
the first did that for me.
Right, right. And that was it. It really touched feelings, and it was a very sort of almost spiritual.
Who made it?
I think it's a newer company.
It's an indie game.
Kind of reminds me of the description sounds like.
And it's on Switch.
Psychonauts. You remember Psychonauts?
Yeah.
First Psychonauts. Like, yeah, I can see that. Going through
different, like, dreams and whatever.
And I've played it all. I've beat it, but I need to go back because I did miss a few things, because you can unlock more. There's a little bit more detailed, and they don't hold your hand through it. So they kind of drop you in, and you kind of just get to experience the journey on your own.
It's a bit more mature of an indie game, like Hell's Blade, Senua's of Sacrifice, and that Dragon Cancer, and things like that. Like, it makes you think as you're playing it. Like, so it's really cool.
I can't think about that game without crying.
Yeah. Let's go ahead and talk about some games really quickly that didn't make the cut, right? Whether they were too late or just didn't. You know, Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order. Well, I guess was not released in time.
Yeah, I guess it wasn't released in time, because this game, I am not, you guys know this, I'm a Star Wars, like, I've watched some movies, but I'm not a huge Star Wars fan. This game is fantastic.
Well, yeah, you're a Trekkie.
Now that I watched The Mandalorian, I'm in.
I don't know what that is. I don't even know what that is.
Shut up, Trekkie.
So Respawn, they did Titanfall 2. They're really good with action games. So this is not a cash grab of Jedi, like, Star Wars stuff. This is a legit, great third-person Jedi swinging game. It's fantastic.
Okay. Gotcha. Okay. Shenmue 3, why is this even on here?
Because we live in an age where after 18 years, Shenmue 3 is here!
But it's not finished!
The story will fit in, but the fact that we have it means that we can't
finish it. I'm not surprised that this isn't on the list.
It was a Kickstarter.
How dare
they leave out Pokemon Sword?
I think that's also too late.
It must have been too late.
Because this Pokemon is great.
You've played it?
You don't play
Pokemon.
That's the thing. I don't play Pokemon.
Did you Twitch it?
What does that even mean? You know what I'm talking about. So, as someone who does not play Pokemon, and I did kind of get into Let's Go, but then I stopped. This is the real deal.
I think the mechanics are really good. I like the changes that they've made. And regardless, Galarian Meowth, isn't it? So
absolutely. So
for me, this should win next year's Game of the Year because of Galarian Meowth, isn't it?
And another game that I think that should be on the list, and maybe it is, I just missed it as far as like story's concerned, Call of Duty. Now again, I am not a first-person shooter kind of person. I don't drive around in a Jeep shooting dudes.
It's in Modern Warfare.
You know, the story behind this game is wonderful. Yes, there's lots of shooting and calling of the duties. It's the biggest duty ever. The story is fantastic. You get strong representation of female, male, and minority protagonists.
Like, I know what happens in the little storyline. Yeah.
You're trying to lure them in with your minority.
Just a bunch of dudes shooting dudes.
But I feel like no matter what, I'm always going to have a weird prejudice against these games.
That my brother plays, like, every Call of Duty he picks up and plays.
But that's the thing.
That's completely okay. I mean,
it's fine.
I don't play dating sims. No matter how you spin it.
You should play the KFC.
Shut up for a second.
Absolutely.
See what I mean?
Like, date the colonel.
Like, you could throw the biggest spin at me.
That chicken leg.
What the hell's wrong with you?
But see, this is the thing. That's the difference. Call of Duty 4 and Modern Warfare 2 had a great story. This is the first one since those that has a good story, multiple perspective, multiple different types of people. It's good. You should check out the story. Now, you had asked me the question, which game do you think should be Game of the Year? And you had asked me the question, which game should be Game of the Year?
I asked Maddie, but...
And then she asked wrong.
And she answered, and your dumbass forgot.
So the Game of the Year, I can't nominate because technically the games I think should win this year out last year, but versions came out this year that I think should qualify. So the game that I put, there are two games that I put the most hours into.
One game,
no,
bro.
No, it's two. I have 6 children and 45 jobs, and I put 180 hours into Dragon Quest
you
11.
You can never be Sophie and Sophie's Choice. I have to choose two of them.
Now, this game came out this year on the Nintendo Switch. It added a lot of content, Japanese soundtracks and voices and things like that. So,
but there's not a limited version of it.
Rob on a technicality.
So this should be RPG of the Year, and also should be Game of the Year, because this game, I've talked about it so many times before.
The Final Fantasy 14 Shadowbringers for RPG of the Year.
Right here, play it.
The second game.
That's it.
The second game is Red Dead Redemption.
That's it.
No. Red Dead Redemption technically came out last year, but on PC. Listen, PC, it came out this year, and it is the best story in a video game I've played in the last decade. The best story I've ever played in this last decade. Yes,
because it's Red Dead Redemption. Only game he's played.
No, not true. I've played most of these
Zero Dawn is the best story I've played in the past few years.
No.
Have you played Overcooked 2?
So those were our picks on what should win the Video Game Awards of 2019.
So what are your predictions? Share them down in the comments below, and don't forget to like and
smash that notification button.
And don't forget, we have a Patreon, we have a Redbubble, we have all sorts of ways that you can contribute and support our channel.
Thank you very much. Keep on gaming. Peace. I said a while. Sorry. Hey. Sorry. So those were our picks for what should be winners of Video Game of 2019.
Hello. Right. Yeah.